Let's imagine you just bought yourself a new speaker system. And of course, now you want to power it with the provided mains adapter. But music alone is not enough for you, which is why you also got yourself an RGB LED strip kit that can be powered without a problem by the provided mains adapter as well. And after choosing the strobe mode, the party can get started, since the LED strip does in no way influence the sound of the speakers negatively. In such a case, we are lucky, because the provided mains adapters seem to correlate with modern EMC guidelines. But to demonstrate an unfortunate example, I chose two mains adapters with an output current rating of 5 amps from my drawer of old power supplies. After I hooked those up to the LEDs and the speaker, and dimmed the brightness of the LEDs to 50%, we can now hear high-frequency interference noises from the speaker. This is a clear EMC problem, also known as electromagnetic compatibility, which describes the ability of a device to not interfere with other devices through unintentional electric and electromagnetic fields, and to function acceptable in its own electromagnetic environment. To solve this problem, the Würth Elektronik eiSos group sent me design kits which mainly consist of chokes and ferrites. So in this video, we will diagnose the existing EMC problem, find a technical solution for it, and at the end I will give you a small insight into other areas of EMC. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by the Würth Elektronik eiSos group. First off, we have to find out how our switch mode power supply creates interferences. For that, we should have a closer look at the simplified functional principle of a switch mode power supply. At the beginning, the mains voltage gets rectified and smoothed out. Afterwards chopped up through transistors, lowered by a transformer, and at the end once again rectified and smoothed out to at last create a low constant DC voltage. Here we can notice that the control electronics use a rather high frequency in comparison to the mains voltage frequency in order to chop up the DC input voltage. Therefore, the created harmonic frequencies could be responsible for the hearable interference noises. The reason is that this chopped up voltage creates a chopped up input current with a fast rise time, which we can not only relocate on our mains voltage as interference, but also gets emitted as electromagnetic fields through conductor loops on the PCB, which basically act as antennas. Therefore, we can define that our disturbance source can transmit its interference to victim devices like our speakers through inductive, conductive, so galvanic, capacitive, and radiative, so electromagnetic paths. Precisely measuring such interferences at home is practically impossible. You need a proper EMC lab for that. But since we know that conductive interferences are most of the time the culprits, we can simply get ourselves such an EMC filter. Without paying attention to the here used component values, we can connect this filter in series to the disturbance source, and with a bit of luck, the EMC problems could easily be solved. That was also the case for our example, since the interference noises of our speaker are now completely gone. But such an unprecise solution is of course not enough for me, which is why I visited Würth Elektronik in order to use their well-equipped EMC lab. There I set up the LED strip kit and connected the interference creating mains adapter to a listen and a spectrum analyzer. Listen stands for Line Impedance Stabilization Network, which in a nutshell is a model of our power grid impedance, across which we can measure the voltage drop. This voltage drop of course contains the interferences of our mains current, whose frequency distribution we can then examine with the attached spectrum analyzer. Thus, this measurement is for the conductive interference analysis. So, after increasing the brightness of the LEDs to the maximum, we performed the required measurements. The result was this graphic, which showcases the critical values for the conductive EMC interferences, as well as the created interferences by the power supply. Like we already suspected, does the mains adapter use a chopping frequency of 40 kHz and also creates interferences up into the megahertz region. But surprisingly, did all recorded measurements lie underneath the critical values? To change that, I connected an adjustable power resistor in order to bring the power supply close to its 5 amp max limits. With those changes, the power supply surpassed the critical values, and thus it was time to find an interference suppression solution. Before doing that though, I placed a current clamp around the L and N wire in two different ways. The reason for that are the two kinds of occurring noises, which are either common mode or differential mode noises. Differential mode noises flow in one direction through the L conductor and return through the N conductor in the opposite direction. A reason for such noise would be the chopping frequency of our mains power supply, but it also creates common mode noises. Those only flow in one direction through the L and N conductor and do not return through them. Instead, they get coupled through parasitic capacitances to Earth and can return this way. So if we place the L and N conductor together inside the current clamp, then the magnetic fields of the differential mode noises cancel each other out because they oppose each other, and we only measure common mode noises since they flow in the same direction. But if we turn around one conductor inside the clamp, then the common mode noises cancel each other out and we only measure differential mode noises. Through this method, we get results which clearly show that common mode noises are the main culprit here. To oppress them, I will be using the Design Your EMC Filter design kit, which comes with all components necessary to build your own filter, even with common mode chokes. Those get placed in series to the L and N conductor. In combination with an X capacitor on the input, they build up a low pass filter for differential mode noises, and in combination with Y capacitors on the outputs, they build up a low pass filter for common mode noises. And in case you have no idea what a low pass filter is, then simply have a look at my basics video about them. But nevertheless, it is important to note that common mode chokes are winded in such a way that differential mode interferences theoretically cancel each other out, and thus cannot be reduced. But since there exists no perfect choke, the asymmetry of both conductor paths creates a leakage inductance of around 1-3% of the original inductance, which can be used to reduce differential mode noises. Now for the common mode noise suppression, we mainly have to look at the insertion loss curve of the choke. So I picked one with a high inductance value, which offers a decent damping from 10 kHz up to 3 MHz. For the Y capacitors, I used a standard value of 2.2 nanofarads, which will dissipate the interferences to Earth. I then picked a 0.15 microfarad X capacitor for the differential mode noises, which in combination with the estimated leakage inductance will create a cutoff frequency of around 20 kHz. At the end, I used an additional 1 mega ohm resistor, which will discharge the X capacitor as soon as mains voltage gets disconnected. Now, hopefully, due to those component choices, we will get rid of the interferences. So I soldered them onto the provided PCB and then connected the finished filter in series to the mains power supply. As you can see, the filter did keep all the interference measurements far below the critical values, and thus there were no more interference sounds hearable from my speakers. That basically means our filter design was a success. but I still want to emphasize that the EMC measurements with the pre-made filter show that it is also a valid solution for such EMC problems. Now, if we open up the problematic power supply, we can see that it comes with a common mode choke as well as an X capacitor, but it misses Y capacitors. Another negative detail comes to mind when opening up another cheap power supply for reference, because this one comes with a metal shielding, which is used to short the radiated electromagnetic fields of the circuits. So, if we for example examine the radiated electromagnetic field of our unshielded power supply with an EMC probe and a spectrum analyzer, we can once again easily recognize the chopping frequency with its harmonic interferences up into the megahertz region. Like already suggested, we can use different shielding materials to reduce the radiation of the circuits. At the end, I think we can summarize that EMC is a very extensive and complicated topic. We can use snap ferrites attached around a conductor, or ferrites wrapped around a conductor, to suppress interferences with frequencies of above 10 MHz. We can use varistors to limit transient overvoltages. We can use rod core chokes to build up filters for DC motors. Or we can use tiny SMD ferrites to build up low-pass filters for circuits during the development of it, or even later on. There is an enormous amount of components and thus solutions to EMC problems. And I hope that I was capable of giving you a small insight into the topic with my speaker example. In case you now want to learn more about EMC, then I highly recommend watching the videos from the Würth Elektronik eiSos group, which you can find in the video description. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hitting the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!